you never know your limit. Every day you have to push harder and harder and harder to get to that point. And you never know where that point is, because until you reach that point, you want to go further. We just need to go there and take it, because it won't be handed to us. Where we're going up a lot against a lot of tough teams, but we can't think about them. We just need to go get our goal and come home.
I need you to conserve some of your energy, Rodrigo. You're working her out hard.
Yeah.
The reason is this. You ever heard of the Jamaican bobsled team, Rodrigo?
Yeah. Shut up.
Emily?
Cool runnings.
Cool runnings. So today, you guys are gonna have some cool runnings.
Are you serious?
We are seriously going near Kingston, and we're gonna train with
what?
These Olympic
what?
Athletes.
Oh my God, yeah. That's
in
awesome.
Jamaica, that's so sick.
What?
There's no snow here.
It's shut up.
Nice.
Cool runnings,
cool
baby!
Running.
You know, while traveling, you make these contacts with people, you reach out. What's the worst people can say? No, I'm not available to meet you. But we got lucky. Who gets to experience a day with the Jamaican bobsled Olympic team? Wayne told me, come on down, bring your friends. We're gonna show you guys how it's done. So Wayne is the coach of the Jamaican bobsled team.
Uh-huh.
Correct?
Yes, yeah. I am.
Nice.
A former Olympian yourself as well?
Yeah, two-time Olympian.
Two-time Olympian.
Wow. Jamaican bobsled started from the idea of two businessmen who were in Jamaica at the time. One wanted to be an Olympian. He was a tennis player. He wasn't good enough to make the US team. So he thought that for him to walk into the opening ceremony with a flag, or representing a team, bobsledding would be a good way for Jamaica. So he started the Jamaica bobsled team. The original members, most of them were from the army.
So what's happening here today? How are you training them?
We're doing some training. We're just warming up. Joel, what's up, no man? I'm not sure if you guys want to join us or we're going to do some warm up. What we're doing now, we're warming up for, then we'll be outside doing some jogging, some stretches,
nice.
Some
okay.
strides, some speed work, and a little pushing on the push track.
Are you going to show us that track,
we're
Wayne?
We're going to demonstrate a little of the pushing.
I like it.
So if we're going to get involved, yeah. We might as well just do some stretching.
Wayne, so the Jamaican bobsled team is iconic across the planet. Can you tell us a little bit why?
I think in the initial stage was a novelty, the people from a tropical country doing this crazy
of course.
Winter sport. So,
yeah.
And I think as we went along, we started to excel, to be a part of the sport, to compete, to be extremely competitive. So I think that is where it comes from.
Holy smokes, I was there for 2 minutes and I'm already dying. Jesus. Troy, these guys are like superheroes.
When we got outside finally and started doing our training outside, it is so hot. Like, I was dripping sweat.
It was intense training. And to be honest with you, I mean, none of us could really keep up with them. However, Emily, Rodrigo, and myself, we gave it all we had.
I can tell you this is not easy.
No?
No. It's incredible to think that there's some people on their team who's never even seen snow, and they're still able to train at the level of the Olympics.
Yo, you were telling me before that he has never get the feeling to do bobsled on ice, really.
Yeah?
Never.
You never done it?
Never done it.
That's crazy to me, though. You have a love for a sport,
yeah.
But you haven't had the real experience for it.
That's it, man.
And that's because you have love, right?
Love. Determination.
Cool. Determination.
With Jamaica.
It's all here.
Is this what your training is like every single day?
Every day.
Do you have Sundays off or?
Only Sunday.
Only Sunday. Yeah.
Bobsled is a full-time job, so you have to, you know, you have to put your all into it. But my goal is to become one of the greatest bobsled driver.
So we're gonna see you at the Olympics then?
Yes.
Nice. We're gonna hold you to that.
So when we got to the tracks and I saw the car and I saw the tracks, it was pretty old school. And that's what they use for training.
They're doing an online crowdsourcing funding campaign that's going to help them with their training facility. I mean, the bobsled that they had got stolen from their track, so they're not even able to train with the kind of sled that they need.
When I see people that they don't have those resources and they still make it, inspire me in my life, period.
Bobsled.
Set.
Set.
Perfect.
Is it like a difference between the way you train and other countries train?
I'm not sure what the other countries do, but I know we based our thing based off speed. If you look at the Germans, they're more power. Some big, powerful guys. I think we're more speed. It's a good strategy. We don't have that height and size, so we go for speed.
I see some big, powerful guys here, so I don't know how big these German guys are, but these guys are fit, man.
You have that love of this sport that you want to do, but what is it for you that inspire you to keep going?
To win the gold medal.
To win the gold medal, for sure.
Yeah. I'm here to win the adrenaline, the whole danger of it.
The whole experience.
The whole experience. It's amazing. It's totally different from track and field, any other sport.
There's some people on the bobsled team who, when they go and experience the snow for the first time, they quit the sport. They can't take it.
There's no way to prepare for it here.
Yeah.
Yeah. We can tell them as much stories as possible about our experience being there, but until they meet it, they will never understand. Mm-hmm. Because I remember my first time done a bobsled track, I was like, I need to go home. I need to go home. And after a couple of runs, I was like, okay, it's too fast, it's too cold. You are tough until
you actually
until
do
you
it.
Until you actually do it.
These guys are tough right now.
Yeah.
But they don't know.
They don't know. What bobsled is until they go in a sled and going down and going fast, 80 miles per hour. Mm. You know what I mean?
Yeah. One time in Königssee in Germany.
We blast the sled off the two men and our driver crashed. I said, what happened, man? I said, go again. And we go again. Then we go again. We crack it again.
But you keep doing it.
We keep going.
Yeah.
We keep going.
Is it an addiction? Do you feel it's an addiction for you?
Yes.
And the more you crash, the more you want to go.
They are addicted to the speed, the adrenaline of the sport. And for them, their determination, I have a feeling, is going to get them where they want to be.
I think we should do a competition between the base campers and the Jamaican team. Why not?
Okay, so we'll have to keep a meeting and get our four best guys to put up against you guys.
Oh,
because you're in pretty good shape, so I
think we're up there. Is he joking, though?
Okay.
I was like feeling hyped for a minute, though.
We need at least one guy from your team.
So you know what? The guy with the funky socks. Yeah, man. All right, demonstration without moving. Smooth. So you guys go first, we time it, and then we go next.
Okay. Yeah.
Yo.
Yeah.
Box fed.
Set.
Set.
Turn set. Seconds.
Troy, you ready?
Ready.
What's the time?
8.89.
That means we won.
There's no way we would
have. What I've been noticed so far in Jamaica, people in Jamaica have great spirit, great mentality, and now spending time with these athletes, it really kicked me in. That nothing has stopped them. They're very driven, they're very focused on what they want to do and where they want to go.
I would really hope that every 4 years, these gentlemen get the funding to follow their passion and their dreams and make that a reality.